Hi everyone. I don't know if you follow me on Letterboxd or not, but back in March, I was trying to watch all the Best Picture winners of the last 20 years. And while I'm still trying to continue with that, I've definitely slowed down since. One of the first ones that I saw was Chicago, the Christmas release musical set in the city of the same name directed by Rob Marshall. In this video, I'm going to talk about my relationship with this film over time and how the Academy comes into play with what I think about it. As I said, I watched Chicago for the first time in March, the middle of March to be specific. I claimed the film to be decent and not a great choice for Best Picture. I didn't care for the characters all that much, and the story felt convoluted and uninteresting, and I simply thought it wasn't my thing. I was confused on why it won Best Picture. And over the next 2 months, I watched a ton of classics films, and I strangely had this film on my mind a lot of the time. Simply put, I just couldn't stop thinking about it even if I didn't like it all that much. I couldn't really remember any of the musical numbers, and the characters just didn't seem interesting to me, so therefore I didn't really remember them or think about them. But the film, I thought about it a lot, and my thoughts on it initially have really changed over time. When looking at the most famous award shows, the BAFTAs are quite spot on with the Oscars compared to the Golden Globes and the Critics' Choice Awards. Maybe not always, and not necessarily for Best Picture, but for sure, most of the other awards. The 2003 award season was a strange one. The Hours won Best Drama at the Golden Globes over The Pianist, while Chicago won the Best Comedy Musical category for Best Picture. Considering what Chicago was up against, it made complete sense. While Adaptation is a film that is more critically acclaimed, it was a bigger frontrunner. Chicago was a bigger frontrunner. At the time, it was not expected to win the Oscar for Best Picture. The Critics' Choice and BAFTAs came around, and sure enough, Chicago won the Critics' Choice and The Pianist won the BAFTA. It was probably a tough decision to choose which one was going to win. Over the past 10 years, the Critics' Choice has been correct on Best Picture 5 out of 10 times, while the BAFTAs have also been correct 5 out of 10 times over the past 10 years. The PGA Award for Best Film went to Chicago, and the DGA Award for Best Director also went to Chicago. The BAFTA, however, went to The Pianist for the Best Director and the Best Picture. When the Oscars came around, Chicago seemed like an absolute lock for director, while The Pianist was most likely going to win Adapted Screenplay and Best Picture. It was quite a surprise when Best Director went to The Pianist, and now it seemed that it was going to win Best Picture, especially after Adrien Brody famously took home the Oscar for Best Actor, which showed how much the Academy really liked the film. When Chicago won the Best Film Award,
Chicago!
It was truly a shock. That was the last movie to win the Best Picture Award without a screenplay or director win, which is quite shocking, especially since it's a musical, and musicals like that usually do win director. Something like La La Land, a film that didn't necessarily win Best Picture, came close, won Best Director, because musicals have outstanding direction. But The Pianist, which is more like a Moonlight in my opinion, won director, and Moonlight didn't win director. So it's kind of weird what happened that year with the award ceremony, and this kind of had into play with what I thought about the movie, because it winning Best Picture without winning a screenplay or director movie didn't help me like the movie more, especially when The Pianist, a movie that I did enjoy, and while it is objectively a better film, won screenplay and director over Chicago, and Chicago was in the same screenplay category. So overall, it didn't really make sense why it won Best Picture, even though now I really like it. So after finding more about the award shows and actually not being able to stop thinking about this film, I decided to rewatch it. And this time, I fell in love with it. I can officially say that this is in my top three favorite movie musicals of all time. The direction and editing and cinematography are honestly some of the best I've ever seen. And while The Pianist is objectively a better film and deserved all the Oscars it won for, and yeah, probably a Best Picture win as well, I have to say, I enjoy Chicago a lot more. All the musical numbers are so energetic and fun. Catherine Zeta-Jones gives one of my favorite supporting roles performances, and the overall style of the film is just so interesting and exciting. Renee Zellweger gives my favorite performance from her that I've seen. And it's just such a perfect film to watch if you're bored. While not everyone's thing, it's certainly mine. I do not know what it was about that first watch, but man, did this get better over time. I've seen this film 3 times now, and I just love it more and more with every rewatch, and I can't wait to watch it again. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.
Cicero. Shakespeare.